The American Association for Cancer Research bringing the greatest minds to San Diego this week. It's all part of their annual meeting.
Cancer researcher Dr. Chris Apfel joins us now this morning, and I want to say thank you for being here.
Well, thank you for having me, Christina. It's my pleasure to be here.
Yes, absolutely. Talk to me about the standard care for cancer in the last few years. Has it changed a lot?
It has not changed as much as we would like to. We spend billions of dollars in cancer research, but if one of your loved ones get diagnosed with cancer, very often the future isn't here now. We are still living in the past. And I experienced this when my father was diagnosed with lung cancer, and he basically refused therapy. He refused therapy because when he took care of my mother, who had ovarian cancer, and the treatment didn't work in her last months of life, he said to me, unless you can promise me this is going to work, I'm not going to have it.
Oh.
And then I said, wait a minute. I thought we are talking here about precision medicine. I thought about the future is here now.
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, genomic testing works only in 1 out of 4 patients. And very often, when patients get chemotherapy, it's hit or miss. So I thought there must be a better way. As a physician scientist, I said, that's unacceptable.
I think most people, doctor, who are watching today, including myself, cancer is something that touches all lives. I've had many family members that have had to fight the cancer, and a lot of younger people in their 40s now having to deal with this. So what has changed? Is something happening that's different, that cancer is becoming more prevalent, or we're just talking about it more?
I think there is more awareness now, but the key is really that once you get diagnosed, you need to be proactive in your care. If you want to be part of it and speak up for your health, what you actually need to do is you need to learn about it, what's happening, what's going on. Screening is very important. That's one part, to recognize it early. The earlier you get it, the higher chance of cures are. If you get diagnosed, let's say you have an ovarian cancer or something like that, you're under scheduled for surgery, what's really important is look at our website at sagematic.com and check out and contact us so that we actually can get a fresh tissue to our lab in order to identify the most effective treatment, which comes to actually, I think, why I founded Sagematic. We have developed a method where we can take a live patient's biopsy, create hundreds of replicates in our lab that are similar to your original tissue, to your original cancer tissue, test dozens of drugs, and have a result to you within 10 days.
When did this come about?
Well, we've worked on this for many years. There has been always an effort to actually do this on live and fresh tissue, but it's so much easier if you throw it into formalin, it's preserved, and then you can look at biomarkers or genomic testing. Working with fresh tissue is actually not that easy. And that's why we actually worked on this for many years to bring this.
This is called the SAGE. Is this the Onco test? Is that what I'm pronouncing it correctly?
It's the SAGE Onco test.
Okay,
right.
So can anybody request to do this, or are there requirements for this?
Anybody can, of course, request to do it, but it only makes sense if it's a tumor that is either surgically resected or if you're failing your standard of care, if the treatment doesn't work for you. In that case, it really makes sense to reach out. Now, you also need to and want to talk with your oncologist. There are two pathways. One is that we call superior care within standard of care, because often oncologists are locked into their treatment guidelines. But then if the treatment is failing, then of course we can also test other drugs, including repurposed drugs, to see whether there is something we can do for you, so that we can go beyond the standard of care.
So by testing this tissue, you run this test, the SAGE Onco test, and then you could come back and say, this would work, this would work, this may not work?
We can very confidently say what cannot work, because when we are exposing the tissue with very high doses that you may not be able to tolerate as a patient, and it doesn't work, and the tumor is still fine and viable and is growing, then we can know for certain this and this cannot work. And then we can quantify, semi-quantitatively say, this one, and that one, those are the, probably your best options.
Insurance covers this or no?
Not at this point. We are fully accredited by the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services to commercialize the assay now. We have actually passed all regulatory requirements, but it's not covered by insurance. So that requires some health economic analysis and demonstrating that you can not only have better outcomes, but also save money.
But this is incredible. So if something were to happen, if you or your family member, a loved one, you know, happens to be diagnosed with cancer, it's something to speak to the oncologist about. Sage Oncotest, and they'll know.
Or
will they know?
It's relatively new. We are working with a couple of oncologists, with Dr. Kessary here from San Diego, who is very much heavily involved in glioblastoma, brain cancer, for example. We are working with Dr. Castro from LA.
Okay.
He is doing a wide range of cancers. He's also very deeply engaged in genomic testing. So creating collaborations is also important. And very often, most oncologists are not familiar with it.
Okay.
So it's important to educate yourself, contact us, so that you are prepared and can speak and discuss it with your oncologist.
Well, we appreciate you coming by. Thank you for this. And hopefully, very, very soon, this will change the way that cancer is doing its thing in this world.
Thank you so much.
We'll get the producer to see if we can put the link up just in case there's anybody watching it so they
on
have access to this test. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.